Many parts of the country and other countries are fighting with excess salt, excess sodium. They will talk about and call it alkali. They'll call it saline. They'll call it sodic. Salt and sodium on the inorganic side is becoming a problem in many, many different areas. One of the tools that we can use is the EC meter to measure how high this salt and or sodium is and how deep it actually goes. We're lucky enough to have Dr. Tom Dykstra with us, an entomologist out of Florida, who has done a fair bit of extensive work with an EC meter. And would you be willing to talk to us about high salt, high sodium, and what you call the dead zone?
I can. So when the EC, which is the flow of electricity, gets too high, there is too much electricity which is flowing. Now, this is not a measure of the energy per se, which is in volts per meter. It's an actually measure of the conductivity, therefore the flow of this same energy. So therefore, it's going to be on a different scale. We use an EC meter. This is a shorter model. There are also some longer models with a 24-inch one. They have different scales associated with them, and these scales are simply adjusted three decimal figures. So we can get a reading of 0.2, which is also a reading of 200. Now, I had mentioned in a previous video that we made that once we get up above 1,200, that we're now into unnatural or inorganic salt levels.
And so, or 1.2?
Or 1.2, either at 1,200 or 1.2. You would measure 1.2 on an EC meter like this, and you would be at 1,200 on some other meters, depending upon what scale that they have. And once you get above that, things get uncomfortable. They get very uncomfortable for all plants.
Some plants. All plants or food plants?
All plants.
Any plant?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Some plants have difficulty with getting, even with the ones that are the salt-based on the shore, they still have difficulty growing. Even though they're getting that salt spray, they still have difficulty growing. Part of the reason why they look like they're doing so well is because there's no competition at all. They're just coming out of pure sand when we see them. But they're not doing fantastic. And so because of that, they could do a little bit better if we moved them away, as long as they didn't have to compete so much. But when you're not competing with anything, cactus, you can do pretty well if you have a way of dissipating the EC, the electrical conductivity, and the cactus does. Then you don't have the competition, and you can handle that level, and therefore you can grow pretty well under those conditions. Cacti, for example, do not grow very fast. Trees grow much faster. We have lots of plants that grow faster. Part of the reason why the cacti don't grow as fast as other plants, they're usually a slow-growing plant, is because of the high EC that they are in. But as far as some of our crops are concerned, when we're above 1.2 or 1,200, they start to suffer. They will have possibly stunted growth. They will possibly have difficulty moving from the vegetative to the reproductive. It's a little high for the reproductive stage. Reproductive stages we're looking to get between 400 to 900 to 1,000, somewhere around there is where you'd want to be. But we're beyond that right now. We're in uncomfortable levels, and these uncomfortable levels are measured by an EC meter above 1,200. And when you do that, the plants will have differential abilities to handle this. Now, they can do so morphologically by dissipating due to the electrical point effect. I don't want to get into this right now, but I'll be in a presentation which we hopefully to get that on the internet at a later date, but I don't want to go into the details of that because some graphics
will help. You shouldn't have brought it up then.
I probably shouldn't have brought it up. What a main mistake.
Moving on.
But we also have the physiological and biochemical way of handling more EC as well. And so some plants simply are better at doing that than others. So once you move up to about 2,000 to 2,500, most plants are not doing well at all. And then certain weeds are the only ones that are left. And so certain weeds, if we're up here in South Dakota, it's going to be in Canada, it's going to be the weeds like familiar weeds like kochia and foxtail, which are often talked about as being found in salt flats and as being the only plants that will grow if the conductivity gets too high. We can have various other plants, certainly down south. We talk about many of the thistles Many of the thistles will also be found in high conductivity. We usually find a lot of thistles in poop patches, where there's usually a fair amount of salt in the poop of the particular animal, and you can get thistles that'll grow out of it. So we can often tell if there's a dog taking a poop on our property, because we'll usually find some thistles. We don't find too many of them, but they can be found under these conditions, and that's their job, is to handle those. So when we move up the scale, it obviously is going to get to a point where nothing grows at all. And that's what we call a dead zone. The dead zone is going to be where no growth can be made. Oftentimes, these can be salt flats. Sometimes they don't look like salt flats. They don't even look that white. But you will see, you know, a brown soil. Everything looks fine. But then you'll place an EC meter in it, and it'll be 3,000, 4,000, 5,000, 6,000 or more. Keep going. 7,000, 18,000. How am I doing now?
We tested our calcium on the salt flats.
Oh, you went to the salt flats.
Yeah,
yeah, good for you. I just saw them from a car.
We wanted to see how tough our calcium was.
It's
so
a good test.
There's a lot of it from 10.0 up to 18.0. We had some that as far as 22.0, which is 22,000.
Yeah.
Which is like sticking a wire into a 110 outlet for a plant.
That doesn't measure up to 22 though.
This will stop working and start blinking at 4.0.
Okay.
Or 4,000.
That's what I thought. That's what I thought. Yeah.
We have other meters that aren't as easy to travel with, but are more accurate for measurement.
That's good.
So with this, and here's something else we found, is when the crop, and in South Dakota, in the Midwest, in the flat grounds, where the crop stops growing, usually at 1.0, 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, we'll see kochia starting to grow. And kochia is trying to get rid of some of that salt. If the salt level gets too high for the kochia, then you'll get foxtail, tickle grouse, what my dad used to call wild barley. And that's trying to extract the salt. And what we've seen is a 1.5, 1.8, even up to a 2.0, we will see the tickle grass, the wild barley, the foxtail will actually grow. And then over a 2.0, you're dead zone. Is that similar to the numbers you've seen?
It is very similar. These dead zones to which we're talking about right now do change a little bit based upon certain locales I have found. So because of that, 2,000 for one is not the same. It might be the same as 2,500 for another based upon certain ways of doing it, though. You can't be sure of this, though, that if nothing grows, you have reached a dead zone. At whatever level it is, it's dead. It can be a salt flat, or it can be something which is moving in that direction and therefore is now past that point of, I wouldn't say no return, because you can return it, but it has reached that seemingly point of no return where nothing will grow. The point of no return has not been achieved even on a salt flat, because as I mentioned to you, I was driving in a car. I didn't get a chance to measure the salt flat, but I was down in Mexico and we ran across some salt flats, hundreds and hundreds of acres, thousands of acres, pure salt flats when I was down there. And because we were in a vehicle, I never stopped. I didn't have the equipment to measure it, but nothing was growing. At that point, someone in the vehicle mentioned to me, well, not nothing is growing. So if you take a look, some animals have passed through the salt flats and they've, you know, squatted and taken care of business. So we got a little poop patty right there. And out of the poop patty is growing vegetation. So I thought, okay, this is interesting. This is a form of regeneration going on here, because we have something that won't grow anything, and now we are adding poop to the equation, and now something is growing. This is really quite amazing, because if we're getting as high as some of these figures that Glenn has tested at 18 to 22, it's hard to believe that a poop patty will remain at a low enough level to support life, because salt will very quickly move up into the poop patty when it's there. But indeed, I witnessed it. There were some plants coming out of it. And so there are ways to get around it. But just be aware, and I think some of you farmers are probably aware of it too, because where the water collects on your property, that's usually where the salts will accumulate as well. especially if you're using a lot of the inorganic salts, the ones that come from the pesticides and the NPK fertilizers that are often used, because they're salt-based, usually sodium-based, and plants don't handle sodium salt very, very well. Having said that, I should probably say there are four different types of salts out there. Sodium salts, they do not handle well. They're a little bit better with the calcium salts, better with the potassium salts, and better with the magnesium salts. But it's the sodium that is mostly problematic for the plants, even though there are four very common types of salts that are out there that can help contribute to it. The sodium salts are causing most of our problems. So I should differentiate because I don't want to give too much of a bad rap to the other salts. They can have their problems, no doubt about it. But the sodium salts are less tolerated among the plant kingdom.
There is a product.
Where would that product be?
Get your hands off me. There is a product. This is why our calcium was formulated. We haven't talked much about this, but our calcium works on remediating high salts, high sodium. We have fixed a lot of these alkali spots. And if you're tired of looking at it, if you're tired of trying to plant it, work it, spray it, and not harvest it, maybe take a look at fixing it. So the calcium, topically applied with water, will grab onto the salt, will neutralize the electricity. You can measure the progress with an EC meter, and you can fix those bad spots. The amount of calcium needed is going to depend on the EC and the amount of salt. Any more thought on dead zones, EC?
No, I think we did a pretty good job of introducing the subject without getting into unnecessary depth.
Okay. We'd like to thank Dr. Thomas Dykstra, the entomologist and famous scientist that's traveled the world. And if you'd like some more information on getting rid of your sodic, saline, high salt, high sodium spots, that's what we do. I'm Glenn with SoilWorks. We're glad you were here. Thanks.